His article wasn't just an attack on barbecues.
It was an attack on America.
Viva Frei, Montreal litigator turned YouTuber, and this is Winnie the Westie, and occasionally I come across an article that is so preposterous, so outlandish, so outrageous, we need to put aside legal questions just to deal with the substantive questions of the article at issue. Fox News, critics roast anti-grill column that urged Americans to celebrate July 4 in the kitchen. Quote, this is hate speech, end quote. Quote, admit it, grilling is bad, end quote, a Business Insider columnist wrote. For those of you who may not know, the article was written by Josh Barro, who is a columnist for Business Insider, and full disclosure, the article is behind a paywall, so I did not actually read the article, because I'm not paying someone to read pure rubbish, but I read his tweet, the world read his tweet, and the world is roasting him the way they're going to be grilling steaks tomorrow on July 4th. Josh Barro, at J Barro, your grill is filthy, has poor temperature control, and for some idiot reason has the heating element below the food so fat drips into it and catches fire. There's a better way to cook, in your kitchen.
What did you say?
To which I responded with the following undumb tweet on Twitter, and if you don't follow me on Twitter, contemplate following me on Twitter at TheVivaFry, although I seem to be a lot angrier on Twitter than in real life. Viva Fry at TheVivaFry, a poor workman blames his tools, winky face. I also retweeted Jay Barrow's tweet to inform him that in a stove, the heating element is also below the food, so fat dripping off the food onto the heating element is not a design flaw.
It is a user flaw.
Now, I was by no means the only person ribbing Jay Bauer for this absolutely idiotic take on the barbecue.
Ribbing? Pun intended.
A lot of other people on Twitter were absolutely lambasting Jay Barro, and some of their tweets were hilarious. Andrew Feinberg at Andrew Feinberg, this is hate speech. Tim Young at Tim Runs His Mouth, quote, quick, it's one of the most popular grilling weekends of the year. Someone write an article shitting on grilling for hate clicks, end quote. Business Insider editors. Beth Bowman at EB454, you clearly suck at smoking delicious meats. Let the brisket master show you how it's done. Ryan Marino at Ryan Marino, who hurt you? Mark at Ethnic Ohioan, you have a sickness of the soul. Now, I say this with a touch of humor, but there always is a little truth in jest. This is not just an attack on the barbecue. This is an attack on what many people perceive to be a core element of American identity, the July 4th barbecue. And these attacks on national identity are nothing new. They've been going on for a while, and we are going through one in Canada where there was just a movement to cancel Canada Day. CTV News, Ottawa News, quote, shame on Canada, end quote. Thousands attend Cancel Canada Day rally on Parliament Hill. Published Thursday, July 1, 2021. And for those of you who may not know, July 1st is Canada Day. July 1st was the day before yesterday, and I put out a very short Canada Day video on my second channel, Viva Family, which you should probably go check out. CBC Kids News. Some Canadians want Canada Day cancelled. What do you think? Let us know in 100 words or less. Here's what you need to know. Canada Day has been cancelled in some Canadian cities. The move is to show solidarity with Indigenous communities. Read on to hear arguments for and against. Some people are questioning whether an annual event honoring Canada is worth celebrating this year. Canada Day is a national holiday that takes place every year on July 1 to mark the date back in 1867 when Canada officially became a country. According to the Canadian government, the goal of the celebration is for Canadians, quote, to show their pride in their history, culture, and achievements, end quote. But some Canadians aren't feeling very proud right now. Last week, the city of Victoria, British Columbia, announced it would be cancelling its Canada Day celebrations following the recent discovery of what are believed to be the unmarked burial sites containing the remains of an estimated 250 Indigenous children adjacent to the former Kamloops Indian Residential School in BC. And for anyone out there who may not know what the residential school system is in Canada, this is a subject on its own, but just a brief overview from Wikipedia. Canadian Indian Residential School System. In Canada, the Indian Residential School System was a network of mandatory boarding schools for Indigenous peoples. The network was funded by the Canadian government's Department of Indian Affairs and administered by Christian churches. The school system was created to remove Indigenous children from the influence of their own culture and assimilate them into dominant Canadian culture. Over the course of the system's more than 100-year existence, around 150,000 children were placed in residential schools nationally. By the 1930s, about 30% of Indigenous children were believed to be attending residential schools. The number of school-related deaths remains unknown due to incomplete records. Estimates range from 3,200 to over 30,000. The way past and even current different Canadian governments have treated Indigenous peoples in Canada is objectively terrible. I don't think we're going to find many people who are going to disagree with that. The question is whether or not you go from these wrongs committed by governments to canceling the national holiday of the country. This move to cancel the national holiday, to demonize the flag of the country because of the historical wrongs committed by the government, is not unique to Canada. It's going on in the US as well. From Psychology Today, is the American flag a symbol of racism? The flag can be seen as representative of white and male power. Posted July 4th, 2020. From The Guardian, I grew up with the American flag, now the stars and stripes seem hostile. Chase Quinn, 4th of July, 2017. And last but not least, from Time Magazine, how I came to view the American flag as a threat. So you can't blame some people for viewing Barro's article not just as an attack on the barbecue per se, but as an attack on the act of celebrating the 4th of July the way Americans have done it for decades. And this attack on the 4th of July celebration itself by no means stops at Barro. It goes all the way up to the White House. Apparently Joe Biden himself threatened to cancel the 4th of July. USA Today ran a fact check on this, wherein they at first called it false, and they had to attenuate their fact check to qualify it as context missing. USA Today, fact check, context missing from claim Biden might cancel July 4 if people don't get vaccinations. This is the Orwellian world in which we live, in which articles online can be modified, edited, and no one would even know, but for the fact that at the very least USA Today, to their credit, indicated that they changed the original article. Editor's note, this article was updated May 5 to detail new CDC guidelines and how previous restrictions on gatherings were set on a state level, not federally. The rating was changed from, quote, false, end quote, to, quote, missing context, end quote. Ah, the good old missing context, where nothing is ever true or false depending on your desires, but only missing context to explain it away the way you want. Our rating, missing context. We rate the claim that Biden might cancel all 4th of July celebrations if Americans don't get a coronavirus vaccine, missing context, due to the lack of specific official statements on this point. Biden hasn't explicitly said people's July 4th celebrations will be canceled if they don't get vaccinated, but he has encouraged Americans to get the vaccine and to keep using masks until the number of coronavirus positive cases goes down. Decisions on how to limit certain celebrations or actions have been made throughout the pandemic at the state and local level, not the federal level. So Biden did not formally announce through official federal policy that 4th of July celebrations were canceled, although he did strongly suggest at one point that if enough people did not get vaccinated, they would not be able to celebrate, and even if they did get vaccinated, that they would only be able to celebrate with small groups of friends and family. Okay, USA Today, thanks for the fact check. But who needs the federal government and Joe Biden to cancel celebrations when it can be done at the state and local level, and when you have mainstream media running cover for the president and telling people to cancel the barbecue
and go cook in the kitchen?
But there is one useful aspect to this rant of a Vlawg. Barro does have one point, even if he didn't know about it, the dangers of the barbecue. Now, by the way, if anyone wanted to know how dangerous the world was, all you had to do was be brought up by my neurotic mother. Growing up, my mother always said, do not use those wire bristle things to clean the barbecue grill because those bristles fall out, and every now and again, people swallow those bristles and end up in hospital. Guard against wire grill brush dangers. Sharp bristles can get left behind after cleaning and stick to your food, posing a risk. July 4th, 2018. With the summer season in full swing, your grill is probably getting regular use. But before whipping up your next batch of burgers, take stock of your grill brush. If you use a stainless steel or brass wire brush to remove stuck-on food from grill grates, be aware of this surprising downside. Small, sharp bristles can break off as you're cleaning and get stuck to your grill's cooking surface. The next time you grill, those stray bristles may adhere to food and be accidentally ingested. Be afraid, be very afraid, because if any of you didn't know this, this number, although not significant, might still be very shocking. An estimated 1,700 Americans went to an emergency room between 2002 and 2014 after having ingested wire bristles in grilled food, according to a study published in 2016 in the Journal of Head and Neck Surgery. One in four of those with grill brush injuries had to be admitted to the hospital. So much like Homer Simpson, Barro might have actually been right on one thing, even if he didn't know that he was right on that thing. If you're going to use your barbecue, be very careful what you are using to clean your barbecue, because if you use those brushes with the metal bristles, those bristles can fall off, end up in your food, end up in your throat, and you can end up in the hospital.
Now we know.
And knowing is half the battle.
G.I. Joe!
Much better than using the wire bristle thingy things is just to use a stick or even just leave that fat and food on the grill, because when it fries up the next time and gets crusted onto whatever you're cooking, it's going to add that much extra flavor. And with that said, to all my American subs out there, happy 4th of July, happy Independence Day. Appreciate your freedom, enjoy your freedom, and above all else, ensure that you preserve your freedom. And I will do the same up here in Canada. And with that said, if you like my videos, you like my content, please be sure to like, share, subscribe, hit the notification bell, and drop a comment in the comment section below, because it feeds the algorithm. If you want to support the channel, all of these support links are in the pinned comment. We've got everything and merch, politics ruins everything. Robert Barnes and I do weekly streams every Sunday. We do weekly streams with a guest every Wednesday called The Sidebar. If you want to support us on Locals, you can find us at
vivabarneslaw.locals.com.
My content is also and will remain on Rumble if you want to catch it there. But more important than anything, take care of yourselves, check in on friends and family, make sure everyone around you is doing well, and now you know your Vlawg. Peace out. Booyah!